Hey guys, welcome back. Last time we played, I actually had an issue with my game where it suddenly crashed. The good news is that this is not going to happen this time. This time we're actually going to enjoy ourselves, and I'm going to show you guys a new solar system because the last one was really boring. Because I actually checked out a couple more things just to see if it was good, but literally there was nothing. So I'll be right back and get you guys to where I am now, where something very interesting is actually happening. All right, so as you can see, this is definitely not the same planet that we were previously on, and a lot of things have changed. But anyway, I'll show you guys really quick what's going on. So I called this solar system Two Brothers because it's two planets. One is Heat Wave, which is not the one we're currently on. The one we're on is Chillin' Flat. There is nothing here, as you can see, low security. I don't even need to get into the rest. The Santals are so dangerous at this other planet. But anyway, instead of me talking and boring you guys to death, let's just get there. First things first, let's go to that monolith. So we're gonna take off. There was some new update, which I have no idea what the update was, but I'm assuming it's something interesting. Who knows? But let's just get over to where we need to be right now. Here we are. So we finally reached our destination. Let's see if there's any knowledge stones. There's normally, well, 2 to 3 knowledge stones are normally around these ancient buildings. So be aware that before you actually go to deal with whatever that thing is. As there, you find all of these. So here's the other one for me. And don't get, confused. That little sign down there is just to show when you reach the place. But anyway, let's move on. I convulse as I reach out and touch the beautiful stone marker, my mind filling with deadly knowledge of the true history of the Gek. The minor Gek are the inferior breed, lurking in pools, procreating and dying without consequence. The first spawn Gek conquer worlds. Each of their spawns is an imprint on the destiny of the galaxy. Wow. Cocky much? My knowledge of the Gek has increased. Oh, I learned about the Viking. The Viking are awesome, by the way. I really want to get back to that galaxy. You probably heard me whine about that in the previous gameplay if you saw it. If not, check the link below for the previous video I've done before. Okay, moving on. So let's get to our ship. And pretty much, guys, this planet is, as you see, it's literally just rocks and more rocks, and I really need plutonium. So let's not even get upset. This is actually a moon, which is the funny thing. It's the moon for this planet over here, which is actually where the Santals are very insane. And I will show you guys this in a second, just after. Oh, wow, look at this. What are the chances of this being right here? What are the chances? Show you guys, yeah, in a sec, like what is over there. But you're gonna see, there are so many gravity balls over there. But it's like every time I get a gravity ball, I'm getting murdered. Ever so gently. Ooh, I'm flying again. And now I am falling. So we got another shelter. Walking distance is 22 minutes. Sounds nice. Let's get some plutonium for the road. Yo, keep scamming me, buddy. You gonna feel it too, just like your brothers on that planet over there that kept trying me. I don't like you guys. Neither does a Viking. And I love them for that. Anyway, moving on. Gonna get back to the ship. And we're gonna get moving on to that area in which has popped up for us. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys. So I think that's a black hole right there. It's an off planet space anomaly. So actually, I'm a dummy. Let me just quickly do this. So no time. Hello. So instead of me actually going to that area that popped up for us there, I'm just going to quickly show you guys this plan so you can see the type of foolishness that I had to endure for a decent amount of time, which is fairly frustrating. Just let me get through the clouds. Whoa, you see all that orange? So I named it Santos or Dangerous here, so for everybody, whoever, if anybody ever sees my planet, how am I still entering? Look how close I am to the ground. But anybody who's here, just be aware, like, there's a lot of good stuff here, but you have to be aware that these Santos are nuts, and I'm going to show you guys, so let me just land right here. Rendering constantly. If they even see you guys, you gotta freak out, because they will come at you. They'll start scanning, and next thing you know, it's your game freaking bum rushed. Let's move on. Any goods here? Ooh, my knowledge of the GEC just went up. More technology. You gonna give it to me? Come on, it just popped up. There we go. I got it. Got some thyme. I don't think I'm being followed. Oh! There he is. Just can't allow him to see me. Let's go in this cave. Wow, this is like the weirdest cave. I wonder if there's even anything good in here. It says there's animals here, but I haven't seen one. Even when I came earlier, I didn't see anything. But honestly, guys, as much as I want to carry on with this planet, I got killed way too many times. And personally, I just want to go through that black hole. I mean, the object is to get to the center of the galaxy and, you know, check out some life forms and see what else No Man's Sky has to offer. Let me see if the ghost is clear. I think I said that analogy wrong, whatever. So I'm gonna save this. If you guys hear any other noise in the background, it's Liana. So, yeah. Don't see me. I'm getting out of here. But yeah, guys, this is a beautiful planet. Honestly, I would definitely say to walk around when you get... It's a flying creature! Which I most likely won't even be able to freaking catch, so I'm not gonna waste my time. But yeah, if you come here, I'm telling you, there is a decent amount of... What in the world is that? Is that the space station? Yeah, I think that is. Yeah, it is. So, we got plutonium. We got a little bit of thyme. Let me actually quickly disturb you guys by gaining some thyme. Excuse me. Because I need it. And now let's get back into the direction we need to go. Only a couple more seconds and we'll be there and we can see what in the world is going on over here. Oh. Well, here I am. I thought it was a black hole, but this looks like the Death Star. I guess we're supposed to go in through this hole. We'll see what's going on here. Oh wow, I freaked out. I thought I was gonna hit that. So, I had a friend that was here before and he told me that this place was nothing but death. But honestly, who am I to say? Whoa. Look at this guy. Hey, nice to meet you, sir. Hey, there's two of you in here. So where's the Viking? You guys got beef with the Vikings? As I approach the electron beam, it springs to life. From its dark mass, scanning beams emerge that envelope me. I completely pronounced that wrong. There is an unnerving chittering sound, and then, unbelievably, it speaks in my language. It offers me a choice. It can show me how to harness black holes in order to embark upon a journey to the center of the galaxy. It can light my way to an Atlas interface so I may follow a path, or it will assist me on my own exploration. Resources to aid exploration. Find a shortcut to the center. Resume the path of the Atlas. So let me think. Let's see what it says. Rare linguinctus form. Pleasure. Okay, assistance offered. So, I think I'm gonna go with the path of the Atlas. I'm not gonna resource it for my exploration, but then again, a black hole gets me closer, so find a shortcut to the center. Fine, whatever. The alien locates a black hole. Thank you, my good sir. You located a black hole, and I'm gonna go talk to my friend over here because he's a geck. What a geck. If only you were to look. Friends all in shapes, all sizes, all places. How do you even look? I mean, what the heck is this? In front of your eyes, how do you see? The shorter entity, a geck, has a jocular air about them. Was it jocular? Whatever. I'm OCDing people. They idly wipe grease-splattered hands on their suit as they address me. Some sort of engineer, maybe. To my surprise, they speak my language. Other life forms have treated me with amused indifference, but Polo treats me like equal. But that ain't Polo, Sway! Anyway, they're curious about my travels, about what sentient species I have seen. If I have met life forms they have not, they hope that I will share my experiences. I'm gonna transmit my data. Polo pours out the data and mutating bitter at beings that they're already familiar with, cheering that thou those that are not. Thank you, Polo, for not letting me read the rest. You're awesome. Ooh, so I just need 10 Hedrium. Cool. Thanks for the Atlas pass, dude. Well, this is cool. Okay. This is really cool. I want to jump in there, but I'm kind of paranoid, like I'm going to regret it. Can I go here? No? Oh, so this is all for show? Okay. Well, thank you guys for your work and dedication. Just by the way, guys, since I've been playing this game, I have actually not followed the Atlas at all. I've been doing my own thing, which is the steady truth. And I couldn't lie. I couldn't lie about that. That is pretty cool, though. So, there's the black hole in the distance. If I could just get to L1. There we go. Okay, this is free exploration, but I need to get over here. This is where I need to get. So, there's a huge jump between that star right there and the black hole. So let's get back to me. And this is path towards the way I need to move. So this is actually the next direction I need to go. So this has class G6, 3 planets, and 1 moon. It's undiscovered, so why not? Okay, so I just went through the building. Look at this, guys. Okay, there, it fixed itself. I know everybody just saw that rock almost take me out. Anyway, so this is an undiscovered area, and I hope I'm not with another different species, because I'm gonna flip out. But let's call this place I don't know why I called it that. Don't question me. Don't question my motives. I do what I want. Okay? I do what I want. So, again. Sorry. So, let me just look back at this again so I'm not losing my mind. This area has 3 planets and 1 moon. Alright, so. Well, this is the closest one, but you know what they say. Never go to the closest thing, right? I have no idea. Let's go to the space station over here, because I actually want to be able to see if we could actually find something that's worth it. Oh, look! It's that robot-looking thing. Okay. All right. What's your name? No name? You know what? Wait, what? Chief Scientist Entity. I'm gonna call you Chief. Alright? And that is not a reference to Halo. So don't even try me. Before I go talk to you, Chief, let me just check out what you got over here. See if I could sell anything. Okay, I can get rid of this platinum. I need the aluminum. Alright, let's see what's in my ship. I actually need this. Alright, nothing good. So let's see if I can buy something. What? Taxing out here like crazy. And it's the same thing for the ship. It's almost pointless. Okay. So, let's move on and talk to this guy. What's up, Chief? Let's see what you know. So, sorry if you guys hear something in the background. It's just my family talking. Oh, man. I have nothing. Let me back out really quick. Let me see what you wanted again. Just talk for me really quick. That's all I need you to do. No, I don't know what anything you said. Wow. Give rare silicon, kryptonite, platinum. You know what? I'm gonna go back and get that platinum for you. Cause you know, you deserve it. Well, this is all that's here, so I'm just gonna get all of this. You're probably gonna be upset with me, but honestly, I could care less. So, be thankful that I'm getting you this, and don't complain to me about anything that I have going for you, because right now, I don't even have enough. Well, that was a waste. I guess I'm gonna have to come back. Oh, that's the wrong entrance. Damn it, Chief. You put up a hard bargain. These life forms are horrible. I don't like any of them. So let's just keep flying around the three meat patties. So this is the moon of Vacant. It actually looks really awesome. Because that planet right there is the one we were just... Or wait, was it? I think it was the one we were just at, but this planet looks awesome. I mean, this moon looks awesome. It'd be pretty funny if a moon was a lot better than its orbiting parent. What is this, the gold mine?
Get it?
Alright, that was really corny. Limited, low, common, okay. Is that a butterfly? What? What? I finally have seen a butterfly. Well, this is awesome. I mean, I really actually was not expecting to see that. Wow, look at these things. Can I get close to you guys? Look how big they are. At least they're not trying to chew my head off, right? How much space do I actually have in my suit? How much are these worth? Wait, I thought he was worth so much more. I'm so lost. Whatever. I'm not gonna freak out over it. I have all this stuff that I probably really don't need anymore. But I'm just gonna hang on to it. Well, I'm just gonna get rid of that cringe. Get rid of that cringe some more. Get rid of this. You can cringe again. Carbon. I always need carbon, but there's more carbon to be found. I need aluminum to actually build something, and plutonium is just common sense. I need it. I need it! You guys know what that's from, but don't tell. Can I scan these? Are they too high? Oy, yoy. I hate chasing these things. Whoa. Okay, they're really high up, so I guess it's gonna be hard for me to get them, but I really want to scan this, so I'll be right back once I get this. All right, so I didn't even bother anymore. Just that poopy creature did not want to cooperate, so I'm gonna scan the place, see what else is here. There's nothing. Is there any animals nearby? Ooh, something's down here. It's in the water. It's in the water. Whoa. Let me make sure that you're not gonna murder me when I come down there. Okay, you're a grazing creature. Alright, we chill, we chill. Oh man, it's not nice when your AI are swimming into a wall. I mean, shout outs to the developers. You guys did what you could. And things happen. I mean, nothing's perfect, but I mean, still, this is, I enjoy this game, so let's just put it at that, even though, this is happening. But why would I judge over something as simple as that? Anyway, let's get over there to the other side of this lake. Nice and easy. Oh, hello. I mean, what is that thing? I mean, it's only appropriate. Call you Pelly. And I'm getting kind of lazy, so I don't want to name that one. I saw these really big blue stones. Oh. Wonder how much the value is for this. Is it better than emerald? Nah, not better than emerald, but still pretty good. There's a cave down there, so I mean, we could check that out. Whoa, that's oh, this is underwater. Okay, guys, so we found an underwater cave, and I just want to see if I'd be able to get out of here. Oh, wow. What? Okay. Wow, that was weird. Okay, that's the first time I've been in an underwater cave. I was not prepared. Let me get that back up. All right, let's go. I mean, this is pretty cool. I mean, this cave goes on for a while. And there it goes. It's showing me that I will be dying soon if I do not figure this out. Oh, wow. There was a hole right there this entire time. Well, I feel like a complete dummy. Wow. That's pretty awesome, though. But I blew an extra hole just in case somebody else comes here and, you know, they want to take a look around. Ooh, suspension fluid, Geknip, that's awesome. Alright, so I'm gonna head back to the ship and see if we can find a location where I could save, and I'll be right back. Alright, I was gonna continue, but I just wanted to show you guys this thing. It's a scavenger, and it's huge. I'm not even gonna wait for it to come at me. I'm just gonna deal with him from now. Look how big this thing is. That's actually really scary. Like, I can't even lie, that's really scary. I do not want to mess with that thing. I hope I do not run into that on the way back, because that is freaking scary. Let me just take a look around really quick, make sure nobody's behind me. That is crazy. I'm gonna call you Big Boy just because of that.
such a simple name, but I mean, it's whatever. So anyway, like I was saying, guys, I'll be right back. I'm gonna head over to the ship. Oh my god! Oh my god, this shit is huge! What? Alright guys, so I'm back. We were getting to the ship and like two more of these things came at me. And I had to do what needed to be done. And that was, oh my gosh, what is that? The meat eaters are so huge here. You gonna scan? I think it's trying to attack that guy, but it's just not working. It's probably a glitch in the Matrix. But that really freaks me out. Like, it literally came out of nowhere. So before that thing glitches back into control, let me just quickly save this. I'm gonna head back to the ship, which should be above this enormous. I'm like paranoid now. I feel like it's just gonna appear out of nowhere. Cause literally two of those guys came up at me. Okay. I really need to wait for my thing to charge. Oh no. Ooh, my thermal protection. I'm not even paying attention. I'm dying over here. It's the best I could do for now. There's some more zinc right by my ship. What a blessing. So, that's all the time I got for this video, guys. The next time we get back, I'll actually be exploring this planet a lot more thoroughly. Because, I can't even lie, this is actually a pretty cool planet with some really cool monsters. And, oh, I thought that tree was a monster. I was about to say, what? So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video, and thanks again for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for new videos every Monday and Friday, and soon Wednesday, I will be posting new videos for gameplay as well, okay? Unless there's another reason why I shouldn't. So, deuce!